What's going on, everybody? We are back with another Battle Pass weapon review. Today we're going to look at the Shotgun ASG-89, aka the Turmoil. So before we get into some matches, let's take a look at what all is its attachments are. So for the Turmoil, starting off, we got a full choke, which adds increases our hip fire spread. So not bad. We also have the precision foregrip, which aids our ADS and our horizontal recoil control, which we'll need because with the extended mag 2, granted we get more rounds, but it dampers our ADS. Obviously reload quickness is trash and our sprint to fire is reduced. So if you notice, our ADS is twice reduced, so, you know, that's not good. So these two kind of like counter each other, so we're pretty much going back to zero. So we also have the assault grip, which helps our sprint to fire, which obviously this dampers our sprint to fire, but we'll you know, we're up by one on that. So it's sprint to fire for rear grip. We also have the infiltrator stock, which helps our aim walking movement speed. And obviously we have the tactical laser. So that's what we've got for the shotgun and Turmoil. We're going to get into some matches now. Just note, I'm either hit or miss when it comes to shotguns, so we'll see how these matches go. Red knife. Weapons free, people. Lay some hate on them. All right. Left. Oh. No, we can't stay in there. We cannot stay in there. Dump shit.
We are requesting UAV tasking.
Ugh, am I playing bots right now? I'm not sure where they're at, so let's see what happens. Try again? Tell them not to.
The enemy's raiding our stash.
enemy's stash. We've located a new crate of gold.
Bion authorizing watchdog helo operations.
Whoops. I really didn't know what the objective was at first. That's probably bad. That's not a good one. I don't know what I'm doing.
Tac op. Launch a UAV.
We're attempting to secure the enemy's gold. Nice.
I stole gold, didn't I?
Tac op. Launch counter UAV.
Move it, nerds.
Bion authorizing napalm strike.
Are we winning?
Enemy UAV inbound. New gold crate identified.
Not sure how he even got me, but okay.
Crimson's on their heels. Hit him hard.
Hey, hostiles are attempting to steal our gold.
The enemy's crates are attacked. Control and Bravo. Secure an Alpha.
What plan was that, dude?
Lock it down, Charlie. Take your Bravo underway.
You guys gonna help me take this?
No, Charlie, lock down.
Nope. I knew I saw.
Bravo, ugh,
come on.
Losing B.
What?
Take it A.
That was six shots on that dude, right?
Bravo. Payback
stings like a
Bravo lock. Charlie. All locations secured. Hold your position. We've lost Charlie.
I cannot kill her. Jesus. Not a fan of this gun. Too many rounds to get through it. Go get him.
Losing B. Crimson's falling back. Hell of a...
All right. After a couple of matches overall with this gun, it does not it does not hit hard. I swear I put about 6 shots into a dude, and finally I had to get a headshot just to take him out. So, close quarters, best bet with this gun. I wouldn't, you know, obviously long shot shotgun, not your thing. This is close, you know, more of a close to under mid range type of assault weapon. I don't even know if this does this have it. Dragon Breath. If you have this available to you, if you want to use this, I would put this on just to ensure you get that. I would definitely take off the extended mag too. It's not worth it for all the decreases you get. If you want more rounds, extended mag 1, sure. Or fast mag. Extended mag 1, reload quickness is lessened, but you get more rounds as opposed to the drum, which does so much negative on you. Okay, hipfire speed, you probably want that for a shotgun. Bullet. I'd go for a reinforced barrel if you can get it available. I like that. It depends on how you want to play this. Like, if you're a mobile person, you like to dive and do a bunch of fun stuff, I'd go for one of these. The CQB grip, probably, or the ergonomic grip. If you're more like me, I would probably go commando grip, aim down sight, and sprint to fire speed. Better stock. I've never been much into putting on a stock, but you know, maybe light stock. I don't think a laser is beneficial, but I mean, it, you know, if you're a runner and gunner and you like to do that stuff, fast motion laser, sure. And I would recommend the Dragon's Breath. Overall, this build version, I wouldn't rock it. Not really, unless you just, I mean, I like the camo is pretty cool, but other than that, I would not rock this build at all. Not worth your effort or your time. You can build a way better version and run with it. This is no bueno, especially with this shotgun being the better of the two. I would not rock this shotgun. So I hope this information helps. All right, next video will be on the Wild Mandrill Black Cell, aka the Wild Mannered. I don't know what word I said earlier. So there are two versions. I'll take a look. I think this one has a couple extra attachments as opposed to this one, but I'll let you know for sure when we go through it. The XM4 is, I prefer this assault rifle over a bunch of the others. So I'll take a look before we start the next video to see if there's different attachments, and if there are, we'll probably do one or two rounds this version and one or two rounds in this version just to showcase it. So as always, I hope you guys are enjoying. If you are, leave a like, leave a comment, let me know what your thoughts are, and hit the subscribe button and help me reach my goal. Peace.